वासुदेवाय ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं उदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिके। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम फिफ्थ कांटो चैप्टर फाइव लॉर्ड ऋषभदेव्स टीचिंग्स टुडे टेक्स्ट 24 धृता तनु उसती मे पुराणी येनः इह सत्वं परमं पवित्रं समो दमः सत्यं अनुग्रहस् च तपस् तितिक्षा अनुभवस् च यत्र धृता तनुर् उसति मे पुराणी येनेह सत्वं परमं पवित्रम् समो दमः सत्यं अनुग्रहश्च तपस्तितिख्यानुभवश्च यत्र धृता तनुरुसति मे पुराणी येनेह सत्वं परमं पवित्रम् समो दमः सत्यम् अनुग्रहश्च तपस्तितिख्यानुभवश्च यत्र धृता तनुरुसति मे पुराणी येनेह सत्वं परमं पवित्रम् समो दमः सत्यम् अनुग्रहश्च तपस्तितिख्यानुभवश्च यत्र धृता तनुसति मे पुराणी येनेह सत्वं परमं पवित्रम् samodamah satyam anugrahascha. Tapastitikyanubhavascha jatra. Ritatanu sati me purani. Yeneha sattvam paramam pavitram. Samodamah satyam anugrahascha. Tapastitikyanubhavascha yatra. Anyway, mothers. Ritatanu sati me purani. Yeneha sattvam paramam pavitram. Samodamah satyam anugrahascha. Tapastitikyanubhavascha jatra. Word meaning. Dhrita, maintained by transcendental education. Tanuhu, body. Usati, free from material contamination. Me, my. Purani, eternal. Yena, by whom? Iha, in this material world. Sattvam, the mode of goodness. Paramam, supreme. Pavitram, purified. Samaha, control of the mind. Damaha, control of the senses. Satyam, truthfulness. Anugraha, mercy. Cha, end. Tapaha, austerity. Titikya, tolerance. Anubhavaha, realization of God and the living entity. Cha, end. Yatra, wherein. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, Abhay Charanarvinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Translation. The Vedas are my eternal transcendental sound incarnation. Therefore, the Vedas are Sabda Brahma. In this world, the Brahmanas thoroughly study all the Vedas, and because they assimilate the Vedic conclusions, they are also to be considered the Vedas personified. The Brahmanas are situated in the supreme transcendental mode of nature, Sattva-guna. Because of this, they are fixed in mind control, Sama, sense control, Dama, and truthfulness, Satya. They describe the Vedas in their original sense, and out of mercy, Anugraha, they preach the purpose of the Vedas to all conditioned souls. They practice penance, tapasya, and tolerance, titikya, and they realize the position of the living entity and the Supreme Lord, Anubhava. These are the eight qualifications of a Brahmanas. Therefore, among all living entities, no one is superior to the Brahmanas. Purport. This is a true description of a Brahmana. A Brahmana is one who has assimilated the Vedic conclusions by practicing mind and sense control. He speaks the true version of all the Vedas. It's confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita 15, chapter 15th verse. Vedaischa sarvai ahameva vedyah. By studying all the Vedas, one should come to understand the transcendental position of Lord Sri Krishna. One who actually assimilated the essence of the Vedas can preach the truth. He is compassionate to conditioned souls who are suffering the threefold miseries of this conditioned life in conditional world due to their not being Krishna conscious. A Brahmana should take pity on the people and preach Krishna consciousness in order to elevate them. Sri Krishna himself, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, personally descends into this universe from the spiritual kingdom to teach conditioned souls about the values of spiritual life. He tries to induce them to surrender unto him. Similarly, the Brahmanas do the same thing. After assimilating the Vedic instructions, they assist the Supreme Lord in his endeavor to deliver conditioned souls. The Brahmanas are very dear to Supreme Lord due to their high sattva-guna qualities, and they also engage in welfare activities of all conditioned souls in the material world. Om Ajnanati Mirandhasya Jnananjana Sailakaya Chakshurunmilitam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurubhe Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vande Aham Sri Guru Sri Yuta Padakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnambhamscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Sa Avadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Visakhanitamscha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namini Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesaha Sunyavadi Paschatya Desatarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauratise Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesaha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneswari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Vescha Kripa Sindhu Bhevacha Patitanang Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Dhrita Tanur Usati Me Purani Yeneha Sattvam Paramam Pavitram Samo Damaha Satyam Anugrahascha Tapastitikya Anubhavascha Yatha Anubhavascha Yatra. The Vedas are my eternal transcendental sound incarnation. Therefore, the Vedas are Sabda Brahma. In this world, the Brahmanas thoroughly study all the Vedas, and because they assimilate the Vedic conclusions, they are also to be considered the Vedas personified. The Brahmanas are situated in the supreme transcendental mode of nature, Saptaguna. Because of this, they are fixed in mind control, Sama, sense control, Dama, truthfulness, Satya. They describe the Vedas in their original sense, and out of mercy, Anugraha, they preach the purpose of the Vedas to all conditioned souls. They practice penance, tapasya, and tolerance, titikya, and they realize the position of the living entity and the supreme law, Anubhava. These are the eight qualifications of Brahmana. Therefore, among all the living entities, no one is superior to Brahmanas. So, here is Lord Rushabhdev teaching to his sons, headed by Bharat Maharaj. There are 100 sons of Rushabhdev. And previous verse, specifically verse 22 and 23, two verse is specifically deals with glorifying the Brahmanas. Brahmanas, in the previous verses you mentioned that Brahmanas are known as Dijo Deva Deva. The worshipper of, because Lord himself is known as worshipper of the Brahmanas or the Lord of the Brahmanas. Two meaning, either is Lord always known as Namo Brahmanya Devaya Go Brahmanya Hitaya Cha Jagad Hitaya Krishnaya Govindaya Namo Namaha. Lord Govinda or Krishna is always known as protector of cows and Brahmanas. That's why Lord is known as also Lord of the Brahmanas. Same time, he is also worshipper of Brahmanas. Sometimes we see how in Dwarka, Sudama Vipra, Sudama Brahmana, he visited the Lord and Lord worshipped Sudama Brahmana. Similarly, Narad Muni also time to time appeared in Dwarka and different places, and Lord also worshipped him. But sometimes, Narada Muni also, all the Brahmanas, they know that their worshipable Lord is Lord Sri Krishna. So, but this verses particularly from starting from 24th and forthcoming verses like 25th, 26th and 27th. In four verses, why Brahmanas are so dear to Krishna, the reason is given. Or what are the specific qualifications of Brahmanas. Shashi Gaur Nitai Ki Jai, Krishna Mala Ram Ki Radha Shyam Sundar. Just like someone born in a Brahmana family, then he became a Brahmana. That is not the proper way to know who is Brahmana and who is not Brahmana. Only son of a Brahmana can become Brahmana. That's why Lord Rushabhdev giving the qualification, describing the qualification of Brahmanas. Why the Brahmanas are so dear to Krishna? So specifically, verse 24th, starting from 24th to 27th, four verses is describing about the qualification of a Brahmana. Who is a Brahmana? One time there was a great debate in West Bengal, in Medinipur district, and there are many smart Brahmanas, they are assembled together. And they were thinking the Brahmanas are better than Vaishnavas, even those who are accepting Vaishnava gurus and known as Vaishnavas. But those are Brahmanas, they are even higher than Vaishnavas. So there was a great debate. And from Vaishnava sides, many scholars are there. And Brahmanas also, they have many scholars, Vedic scholars. And His Divine Grace Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur also present, was there in that assembly. And when he get the chance for speaking, first he glorified Brahmana just like Rushabhdev. He glorified Brahmanas in previous two verses. He glorified Brahmanas like anything. Brahmanas, no one can be comparable to Brahmanas. They, even Lord himself, he worshipped Brahmanas like that. Similarly also, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he glorified Brahmanas like anything. Half of his lecture, he simply glorified Brahmanas. No one is dear to Brahmanas. Brahmanas are Dija Deva Deva, they are Nama, very dear to Krishna. And even Krishna himself worshipped Brahmanas like that. So Brahmanas were clapping and telling, what a very wonderful person. Actually, where is he? He is coming to a speech for in favor of Vaishnavas, but he is glorifying Brahmanas. They all become very happy. But in second part of his lecture, he spoke about who is Brahmana. Similarly, we see here also Rushabdev, after glorifying Brahmanas in previous two verses, 22nd and 23rd, then in 24th, starting from this verse, he is telling who is Brahmana, why Brahmanas are dear to Krishna. Not simply someone born in a Brahmana family, then he is dear to Krishna. Not like that. Krishna also told in Gita, Chaturvarna Maya Susta Guna Karma Vibhagasaha, according to quality and activities. Then one can be known who is Brahmana, Vaya, Khatriya, Vaishya or Sudra. So here is, in this verse specifically, eight qualities of Brahmanas are described. And again, other verses also, other qualities are described. Brahmanas are Niskinchana, Brahmanas are very merciful to conditioned souls like that. In previous verses also, 25th, 26th, 27th, also the qualification of Brahmanas are mentioned. But particularly in this verse, there is eight qualities as mentioned. Who is a Brahmana? Brahmanas are situated in supreme transcendental mode of nature. They are in Sattva-guna. Brahmanas are always in mood of goodness. That is the first quality of a Brahmana. Brahmana must be in mood of goodness, not in passion or ignorance. Brahmanas are in mood of goodness. That's why they are always engaged in studying Vedas and Vedic literatures. Swadhyaya. Jajana, the six activities of a Brahmana. Jajana, Jajana, Pathana, Pathana, Dana, Pratigraha. Jajana means he performs yajnas and he also teaches others how to perform yajna. So in this Kali Yuga, what is yajna? In Kali Yuga there is only Sankirtana yajna. Krishna Varna Tisa Krishnam Sangha Panga Viparsadam Yajna Sankirtana Prayari Jajanti Hi Sumedhasa. Who is most intelligent person in this age of Kali, they accepted this Sankirtana yajna, that is preached by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, or started by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he always did Sankirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. That is yajna. He himself performs Sankirtana yajna, he and teaches others Sankirtana yajna. That is Jajana Jajana. There is some Karmakani yajnas also and other yajnas. But they are not recommended for this age. For this age, there is only Sankirtana yajna. Hare Ranama, Hare Ranama, Hare Ranama, Iva Kevalam, Kalo Naste Iva, Naste Iva, Naste Iva, Gatiranyata. This is yajna, Sankirtana yajna. Jajan, Jajan, Pathana, Pathana. And Brahman always engaged in studying Vedic literatures. He don't do prajalpa, don't talk to others, mundane things, criticizing someone, talking about nonsense, aversions, not like that. Brahman is always talk about Krishna. He engaged in studying analytically Vedic literatures. Pathana and Pathana. Pathana means he also teaches the same thing. What he learned from the Vedic literatures, then he also teaches the same knowledge to others. Dana Pratigraha. Brahmanas accept charity. That is Brahmanas. Anyone gives some charity to Brahmana, Brahmana immediately accepts the charity. But what will do that with that charity? Pratigraha, he will give everything in charity to in Krishna's service. He don't stock anything. Practically, Brahmana have no bank balance. Brahmana did not keep any stock for future. Even they don't think about the next day. They completely depend upon Krishna. That is real Brahmana. So here is the verse telling the first, that is the first quality of a Brahmana, his mood of goodness, Satya Guna. Because of this, they are fixed, because they are always engaged like this, that's why they are Sama. Sama means control of mind. Their minds are under complete control. Like also in a Bhagavad Gita, in 18th chapter, Krishna also telling about, he also told about qualification of a Brahmana. Sama, Dama, Tapah, Saucha, Khyantir, Arjavayavacha, Jnana, Vijnana, Astikyan, Brahma, Karma, Svabhajam. And this is the qualities. There is 9 qualities are explained by Krishna in Gita, and here is 8 qualities, and other qualities are in forthcoming verses. So Sama. Sama is a Prabhupada translated fixed in mind control. His mind is completely fixed at lotus feet of Krishna, his Brahmana. Savai Manaha Krishna Padaravindaya. His mind is always under control. Not only mind, Dhamma, because his mind is under his control. So Dhamma means control of senses. His senses are also under his control. But how he keeps his mind and sense under his control? Not by artificial means, by hatha yoga like Vishwamitra or some other yogis. Vishwamitra also is trying to control his mind. He was in samadhi, practicing Ashtanga yoga. But when Menaka came and simply just hearing the tinkling sound from his ankle belts, his meditation broke. Not like that. That is not Krishna. That is mind. He fixed his mind at lotus feet of Krishna, and senses. The senses are fully engaged in service of Krishna. One can control his senses by engaging them in service of Krishna, not by meditating on jyoti or some other ways. So a Brahmana, he is a Sama and a Dhamma. These two qualities there. Is control, mind control and sense control. And Brahmana is truthful. He is always speaks truth. Brahmana never speaks lies. That is quality of a Brahmana. See, because in Satya Guna, he never speaks lies. He always speaks truth. What is truth? What is only truth? Krishna. Krishna and Krishna's name. And Krishna's devotees, they are only truth in this material world. So they are always engaged. Matchita, madgata, prana, budhayanta, parasparam, kathayanta, samam, nityam, tusyanticha, ramanticha. So he always engaged in talking about Krishna and Krishna's pure devotees. And in this way, he engaged himself completely discussing transcendental topics. By this, he gets immense pleasure by simply discussing about Krishna and talking about Krishna, serving devotees. And so that's why Brahmana always speaks truth. He don't speak lies. What is meant the definition of truth? Truth also must be utilized for protecting religious principles, dharma. Otherwise, like one time some dacoits just following one rich person, and that rich person just fearing he has great wealth with him. So he has fearing, then he enter one sadhu's ashram and just hide in some behind of his cottage. Then the dacoits also came. They asked sadhu, "Oh, you are a Brahmana, so we know you cannot speak truth. You will speak always. You will always speak truth. You cannot speak lie. So you must speak us truth. Where is that rich merchant? Where is he hiding?" This Brahmana, this sadhu told, "Okay, yes, it is true. Why I should speak lie?" He told, "Yes, he is hiding in back of him." So immediately the dacoits cut him and kill him and just plundered all his wealth. So that is not real truth. Truth must be for the service of Krishna. The actual truth is just like Krishna told Yudhishthira Maharaj to speak lie. Why? to speak this, this Dronacharya has, no, sorry, Asvastama has died, the son of Dronacharya. But Yudhishthira Maharaj also thinking, how can I speak lie? It is not duty of a Vaishnava or a Brahmana. How can I speak lie? But whatever the dharma to sakyat bhagavat pranitam. Whatever Krishna decides, that is truth, that is real religion. So that's why Brahmana is also truthful, but that is to establish Krishna as the supreme truth. He speaks truth to establish that Krishna and the literature which glorifying Krishna, that is only truth. Krishna and his devotees and the Vedic literatures, there is only truth. So that's why he is mentioned that Brahmanas are truthful, satya. And what when the Brahmanas, they explain, because they always read Vedas, so they always describe, they also discuss Vedas. They describe the Vedas as in their original sense. Original sense, what is the real meaning of Vedas? They don't give their own false interpretation. Sometimes people interpret, like Shankaracharya, he interpreted Bhagavad Gita, Vedanta Sutra in his Sharirik Bhashya, in his own way, Mayavada Bhashya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, Mayavada Bhashya Sunile Haye Sarvanas. One should not, a Vaishnava should not hear about Mayavada, is interpreted by Mayavadi Acharya or someone. So that's why a Vaishnava, he described like Prabhupada, he wrote Bhagavad Gita. Then when he gave his commentary, then it is as it is. As it is. There is no speculation. Not his own own ideas. He is only established the truth what Krishna originally want to spoke in that verse. And he followed the acharyas, Vaishnava acharyas in this commentary. And then he wrote his Bhakti Vedanta commentary. He not speculate. Don't give his own opinion like that. So that's why Vaishnava is always interpret Vedas in their original sense. And they are always very merciful. Anugraha. Anugraha means mercy. Prabhupada in his purport specifically wrote his purport on this point. Anugraha. Vaishnavas must be a preacher. He must preach for the welfare of the conditioned souls. Vaishnavas are para dukhe, dukhi. If he is not a preacher, then how can he, what type of Vaishnava? What type of Vaishnava? That's why Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say, Vaishnava ke, who is a Vaishnava? Dushtaman tumi kisera Vaishnava. What type of Vaishnava you are? Pratishthara bhare nirjanara ghare tava harinama kevala kaitava. To get some name and fame and you make so small cottage, and back of Radha Kund or somewhere in secluded place, then you want to imitate Haridas Thakur. I chant every day. It's not possible to chant, imitate Haridas Thakur chanting 192 rounds, 3 lakh names every day. Or some people, they think like that. That is Bhakti Chansar Thakur and Srila Prabhupada, they don't like. They told this is cheating. Because Vaishnava is one of the quality of a Brahmana is also that anugraha. Anugraha means merciful. He is very merciful for conditioned soul. Prahlad Maharaj told, I don't follow this path. Many Brahmanas and many tapas, many devotees, they want to go to Himalayas and sit in gumphas and meditate on Brahman. They were concerned about him themselves to achieve liberation free from birth and death. But I don't want to go alone to Supreme. Abode. Even Nrsingadev himself was asking, Prahlad, you suffered so much for other living entities, the messengers of Vishnu, they come to take them. But here is only he himself, Supreme Lord himself, Nrsingadev came personally to take Prahlad with him. He told, come with me, personally I take you. But Prahlad told, no, I cannot be selfish. I have to follow the footprints of my Guru Maharaj, who? Narada Muni. Because of his mercy only, you appeared here. How you are in front of me? Because of, I got the special mercy from Narada Muni, who taught me all these principles of how to perform devotional service unto you. So unless I taking permission from my guru, and how can I go with you? I have to follow his principles. My guru is not in your abode. He is also traveling and preaching. Who can be greater preacher than Narada Muni? Let us sometimes, Prabhupada is also known as Narada Muni, for the modern age. He is also Narada Muni, like he is traveling and preaching. So that is Vaishnava. He is very merciful. Anugraha is very merciful. They preaches the Vedas to the conditioned souls. Unless one is a preacher, he is not a high class Vaishnava. Vaishnava is not selfish. They are always traveled and preach. So that is one quality is mentioned here, anugraha. Then they practice penance, tapasya. Brahmana, that is Krishna also mentioned there, samadama tapa. Then samadama, after sense control, mind control, then tapa. Here is also telling tapa, tapasya. Austerity. What is the definition of austerity? To accept voluntarily bodily sufferings or miseries for the spiritual progress. Just like we perform austerity in Ekadasi fasting. No one like to fast, but we have to fast on Ekadasi. If you do Nirjal, that is better. Krishna will become very pleased when you see that devotees are performing such austerities, doing totally even fasting from water. Ekadasi is coming. It will come in sometimes in June. June or beginning of July, this Nirjal Ekadasi, Bhima Nirjal Ekadasi. Even the Bhima, such a great voracious eater, he also fasted on that day without taking even water. So this is austerity. A Brahmana likes to perform some austerity. He don't hesitate to perform austerity. He do some, he like, that is his quality. He likes to perform some austerity voluntarily. He pleased with that. This is tapasya. So greatest tapasya is in this age of Kali to follow the four regulative principles. That is the greatest tapasya. No intoxication, no meat eating, no gambling, and no illicit sex. Otherwise, one time once Srila Prabhupada's godbrother was in London, then the prince of England, he asked, "Can you, Swamiji, you can make me Brahmana?" He told, "Yes, I can make you Brahmana." What is, they told, then first we have to follow these four regulative principles. And when he explained what is the regulative principles, he told, "It is impossible. I don't want to become Brahmana now." So if someone want to Brahmana, then first thing, you have to follow the four regulative principles. We see many people, they born in Brahmana families, they claim themselves Goswamis, and they are maybe working in some factories in Kanpur. So it is not Brahmana. He must be, he is act in such a way that he proved that he is a Brahmana by his quality. Guna karma vibhagasa. So that's why tapasya, Brahmanas do tapasya to why they do tapasya? To please Lord Sri Krishna, not to please the demigods. Sometimes people say like Hiranyakashipu, who can perform austerity like Hiranyakashipu? So just stand on one leg, one finger, putting two hands up, 5,000 years standing like that. Even his whole body was eaten by the, what? By the ants, and his only skeleton was there, still he was. But Vaishnava is not performing such austerities just for material sense gratification, to get some siddhi or to get some sense gratification. The austerity performed by the Vaishnava for the Brahmanas, real Brahmanas, only to satisfy Krishna. That's why austerity not, Krishna not like austerity, that is not mean to satisfy Vishnu. There is in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's time also, there is one Brahmachari who was in Navadvipa. He was a great, performed great austerity. He was not eating any grains, only eating what? Banana and milk. Dudhari Brahmachari, he is only drinking milk. And he wanted to see the, what? dancing of Lord Chaitanya in Shivas Thakur's house in night. And he was again and again he was always in Sattaguna, he was not speaking lies, all other qualities of Brahmana were there with him. He was performing austerity, but Shivas Thakur thought, okay, he is a Brahmana boy, he is born in a Brahmana family and all these good qualities with him. He will not even grain. He is only drinking milk and always in mood of goodness. So he allowed him to stay in his house. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and when starting little dance, then he told, okay, today I am not feeling happy. Some unwanted person is here. So Shivas Thakur, what can he do? You understand? I cannot hide anything to Mahaprabhu. Then he told, disclose that this is a Brahmachari from Navadvip. He has performed great austerity, only drinking milk. He don't eat even grains. And all qualities of Brahmana in his character. So he has a desire to see your dance. So he requested me again and again. So I gave him a place to stand and see your dance. Mahaprabhu told, kick him out again. Immediately kick him out. Unless someone surrendered unto me, he cannot see me by simply performing some austerity. My dance, one want to see my dance or get my favor, but then first thing is to surrender. Immediately kick him out. But this Brahmachari was very intelligent. I immediately fell down in feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and begged forgiveness and he surrendered. So that's why austerity must be for pleasing Krishna. Austerity is like Ekadasi, Janmashtami, Narsingha Chaturdasi, to remain fasting on those days, that is recommended in Shastra. Other austerity is like someone want to do some austerity to get some siddhi, to some other things, to please some demigods, that is not austerity. This is cheating. So that's why even austerity is only recommended for Brahmanas. The Brahmana, that is their quality. And then next is telling titikya, tolerance. The next quality of a Brahmana is tolerance. Even Kapila Dev told that the first quality is tolerance. Titikhyava karunika suhuda sarvadehinam ajata satrava santa sadhava sadhubhusana. Brahmanas are also known as sadhu. The first thing is tolerance. Tunadapi sunichena tororapi sahishuna amanina manadena kirtaniya sadahari. Tolerance. One must tolerate, more tolerant than a tree, and more humbler than the grass on the street. In that humble mood, giving respect to everyone and not expecting any respect for himself, in that mood one can chant Hare Krishna day and night. So Brahmana is tolerant, he tolerant everything. Even someone give him pain or harm him, but still he pray for his welfare. He is real Brahmana is who has this quality, not just born Brahmana. Durvasa was a born Brahmana, but he immediately became angry and he was trying to do some harm to whom? Maharaj Ambarish. But he was who defeated? Maharaj Ambarish or Durvasa? So even a born Brahmana, if you will not control your senses, you will be in trouble. But you see Maharaj Ambarish, he is simply standing. So actually a Vaishnava, he automatically get all the qualities of a Brahmana. If someone is surrendered to Krishna, then all other qualities, Krishna ika saranam. If you surrender to Krishna, that is among the 26 qualities of a Vaishnava, the greatest quality is, the topmost quality is Krishna ika saranam. First, if you surrender to Krishna, then all other qualities will come to you with the mercy of Guru and Krishna. They will come to you. So, and that's why tolerance, must tolerate. The Haridas Thakur, though he was not born in a Brahmana family, he was born in Muslim family. But when he was beaten in 22nd market places, but still he was tolerating. He was praying to Krishna. Oh Krishna, what these people are doing, they don't know. Please excuse them. Sudarshan was in skies, appeared to kill all those miscreants. But Haridas Thakur was praying for their welfare. Tolerating. And again, praying for their welfare. That is a real Brahmana. That's why when Advaita Acharya was performing his sadhana ceremony, then the what is tradition and the culture, Vedic culture, and when some jagya or some important function like offering in Pitru Sraddhas for the satisfaction of the forefathers, that is offered to Vishnu, and after offering to Vishnu, the first person who has to be fit must be a Brahmana. So Advaita Acharya performing his Pitru Sraddha, then he first feed to whom? Haridas Thakur. He invited Haridas Thakur and first feed him. Haridas Thakur telling, I am a Javan, I am a Muslim, born in a Muslim family. Why you are feeding me? There are so many Brahmanas. Please, first feed to the Brahmanas, just like previous verse Krishna is telling, that I like to, I became very pleased when a Brahmana eats food. It is better to offer food to a Brahmana than to offering a jagya, in a fire sacrifice. Krishna eats in two ways, in fire sacrifice, something offering in fire sacrifice you can offer to Krishna, or to offer the Brahmanas, Vaishnavas. Krishna eats through the mouth of Brahmanas. So Advaita Acharya feeding Haridas Thakur, Haridas Thakur was crying, no, there are thousands of Brahmanas are in line, you give them first. How are you giving me? I am a Muslim. I am born in a Muslim family.